As a parent of three children who are in soccer programs, I spend my weekends going from one part of this valley to the next. Even though I may not live in a city, I still use their parks. And that's the idea of having regional parks, is that they're here for all of us in Salt Lake County, whether it's in our city or not. Now that we own these properties in Draper, Bluffdale, the West Valley Kearns area, we can now build the parks on these 60 to 80 acre parcels. The people are already living in those communities, and so now is the time to build.
And that's what's on the ballot now for November, is a $47 million election question, asking voters if they want to tax themselves to now improve those parcels of properties and turn them into parks and trails. We've calculated the tax impact for the county. The tax impact is estimated to be $5.73 on the average home. There is a concept called generational transfer, that those who actually use the facilities ought to be the ones paying for the facilities, and issuing debt allows you to do that.
The best time to create a park would have been 20 years ago. The second best time is now. We need to take action to save these lands, to create these parks so that generations right now and in the future will be able to use them. If we wait for our children to do it, there will be an entire generation that won't have the ability to recreate at these parks to enjoy the benefits of them.
Really, if we don't vote on this bond, then we can't build these parks. My philosophy is that I'd rather build a new park than build a new jail. And this year we've got a Parks and Trails bond on the ballot, and we want people to support it. This project, it's about parks. It's also about trails as well. So we'll complete the Jordan River Trail. We'll also complete the Parley's Trail, which goes from Olympus Cove to the Jordan River.
The Jordan River flows almost 50 miles from Utah Lake in Utah County, about Lehigh-Saratoga Springs, north to the Great Salt Lake. It's one of the few rivers in the nation that actually flows north. It flows through 15 different cities, 3 different counties, and really ties us all together. The Jordan River has had an interesting past. As people developed additional drinking water sources and additional irrigation sources, the river transitioned into more of a wastewater deliverance system. And there were times when slaughterhouses and sewage, raw sewage, was just being dumped right into the river, and the water quality really degraded, and it became a major problem. But if you come down here today, you'll see that it has improved dramatically. We have beautiful trails, beautiful parks, golf courses.
You know, if you think about it, somebody had a lot of foresight way back when, in setting aside land for Liberty Park in downtown Salt Lake, a large open space that's now well utilized. And I think the thinking is that we need to have the same foresight in setting aside large tracts of land and park space in the south area of the valley.
I always describe what we're doing as like owning your own home. You can save up for 30 years and then live in your homes at the twilight of your life, or you can live in it now and pay it off as you're enjoying it. It's important to preserve open space now, because if we wait 10 or 20 years, this valley will be built out and we won't be able to do so. So if we can preserve the land, build the parks when the growth is there, it really just makes sense. We're planning ahead rather than reacting.